So, David, let's talk about first about portfolio structure, because I think there's a really interesting way you manage your portfolio. Very concentrated, about 10 positions only.
Exactly.
And really focused on value.
Exactly.
Why do you do that?
Because we think a private equity-like approach, highly concentrated, small ratio of portfolio companies to investment professionals is the best way to touch these companies and help them build shareholder value.
Now, this is really a stock or investing show. It's a show about technology. But I'm really interested in how you look at the sector of technology when you're trying to decide what stocks to own. And particularly as a value, there, you know, these value value guys and this value investing Congress, tech stocks are not really a popular topic because the valuations are often so stretched.
There are several other reasons, too. Revenues are cyclical. There's growing international competition. There's short product life cycles and getting shorter all the time. A lot of the time when they try to explain what they do it in a language which isn't comprehensible unless you're a technologist yourself, which is very different from other kinds of businesses. And finally, and this is the thing that concerns me the most as a value-oriented investor, many technology companies surround themselves with what I call a green cocoon. They have unbelievably excessive amounts of cash, which they justify because of historical growth rates of their industry or historical volatility, and they're not thinking about how to use that precious resource to build shareholder value.
Well, you look at Apple, you look at Microsoft, you look at Google, these companies have got these war chests of billions and billions of dollars, and maybe with the exception of Apple, which really uses it to advance purchase products, they just sit on it.
So there's things they need to do about it. They need to be thinking about regular dividends. They need to be thinking about extraordinary dividends. They need to be thinking about possible share repurchases. And also, there are acquisition opportunities.
Yeah.
All of those need to be thought about, but they all need to be thought about relative to one another rather than in a silo, rather than in isolation.
Well, and we're going to talk about Microsoft later in the show with Glenn Tong. It's a stock that he really loves. Even the market's been beaten up on it lately. Really quickly, what do you do when you're looking for a stock in technology or without? What's the sort of one thing that you really look for?
I'm not going to give you one. We want financial strength in terms of a strong balance sheet, and we want to be able to see positive operating cash flows right through the business cycle. We want to see leadership in a reasonably defined business niche, because everything I learned as a business analyst says that leadership creates the potential for extraordinary profitability. And we want to see strong management whose personal interests are aligned with those of the outside shareholders.
Well, I tease that you got a stock pick, and I want to talk about this company, Radisys. You're on the board. They just reported numbers like an hour or two ago, better than expected. They're doing an acquisition. What is it that you see in those categories that you just described in Radisys?
Well, first of all, from a valuation point of view, one of the things that's intriguing to us about Radisys is that its valuation seems low to us. Its total enterprise value relative to its revenue run rate is only 0.5 in a sector where other companies are typically trading at perhaps three times that much. There are reasons for that, and I think that the acquisition that they announced today of continuous computing can go a long way towards alleviating some of those challenges and building some real growth and profitability into the combined company.
Now, we talked about earlier today, you were describing sort of two sectors with the company, because the stock's done nothing for a long time. But two sectors within the company, one that's going up and one that's going down at the same rate, so it looks like nothing's getting better there.
That's been one of the problems, absolutely been one of the problems, because it's almost been half and half between legacy businesses, which are going away at about a 20% rate, and new forward-looking businesses, which are growing at about a 20% rate. But this acquisition changes the revenue mix such that next year, roughly two-thirds of the revenues are going to be forward-looking, and it's going to be a different company, not only because of that growth, but also because Continuous's gross margin is about two-thirds higher than Radisys.
Gross margins will go up.
Gross margins will go up. The growth will go up. There'll be opportunities to save costs in terms of cost of goods and in terms of below the line. And there are a number of managerial changes, which I think will strengthen the ability of the company to strategize and execute well.
All right, we got to go. But David, that's great stuff. Interesting. We're going to watch what happens with Radisys, because it could be a good one to watch. All right, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Bloomberg West.
Thank you. Bye-bye.